Hey everyone. Today I want to talk about a place a lot of us, I think, find ourselves in where we want to do something but we don't get noticed. A month ago, a high school senior did something really interesting. So it's really difficult to get into an Ivy League school. Schools like Stanford have like a 4.7% acceptance rate. It's crazy hard, right? This doesn't surprise you. Well, Brittany wrote a college essay about a month ago that got her not only into one school, but into five Ivy League schools, including Stanford. So what did she do? Well, she wrote a really interesting and original essay about Costco. And a lot of people are talking about how original it is, but I think they miss an important point. Let's start with something else. So original advertisements, right? I imagine you've probably seen a highly original advertisement, right? During a Super Bowl, whatever. And you've probably, a day or two later, you can remember the ad, but you don't remember what it was for, right? So that wasn't very effective. That was probably a failure, right? So a guy named Rick Peters, a professor in economics, wanted to figure out more about original advertising, right? Companies spend a great deal of money on original advertising. So he wanted to see, does it actually work? Can we actually measure the effect? So he got about 120 participants to look through magazines and to, he then set up corneal eye tracking hardware or something to track how much time people spend looking at ads. And so he then, and then had a separate group of judges rank these ads as to how original they were so that he could have some measurement. Are original ads affecting people? Does it get them to pay more attention to these original ads? Well, it's probably not surprising, but it turns out, yes, original ads do get people to spend a little bit more time on those ads. Their eyes were tracking those ads a little bit longer. But he also wanted to find out, how does it affect familiarity? So familiarity is something that's a little different. Even an original ad can become familiar, right? Like Dos Equis' Most Interesting Man in the World ad. It's extremely original, but you've now probably seen it about 100 times, making it very familiar. But also ads can just seem familiar, right? An ad about a minivan probably seems familiar because you've seen a million minivans, right? We're very familiar with this concept of a minivan. So here's what happens though, right? We skim over familiar things. And so advertisers have a problem when something becomes familiar. So Rick wanted to know, does originality of an ad kind of mollify the effect of something becoming familiar? So he also had another group of judges rank these ads as to how familiar they seemed. And so again, you might not be surprised, but originality does improve familiar ads. When it's an original and familiar ad, people spend a little bit more time than, say, an unoriginal familiar ad. But here's the thing. It wasn't just more effective. It was the most effective. So you might kind of suspect an original and also an unfamiliar ad would get the most impact, right? We've never seen anything like this before. It turns out that's not the truth. An original ad about something that seems familiar gets the most impact. People pay the most attention to it and they remember it better. That's an effective advertisement. So going back to Brittany's essay, if you read some of this, I'll read the top quote. It starts off really original, right? So managing to break free from my mother's grasp, I charged. With arms flailing and chubby legs fluttering beneath me, I was the ferocious two-year-old rampaging through Costco on a Saturday morning. Right? That's original. That doesn't sound like a college essay. That sounds like some sort of kind of humorous fiction we're about to kind of get into. But here's what's kind of interesting, right? She starts getting into the familiar. Costco. There's like 80 million Costco members, right? And a typical Costco member is college educated, makes over $100,000 a year, right? That sounds like the type of people who are probably reading her college essay. And it just so happens, right? So we are all very familiar with Costco. She writes, I contemplated the philosophical. If there exists a 33-ounce jar of Nutella, do we really have free will, right? Some of those same things seem probably familiar to you, right? Watching someone carry around a giant tub of Nutella, like what are you going to do with that, right? So she writes an original essay, but she attacks the familiar. And that's why this stuff sticks in our head so well. So I mean, imagine if she wrote this essay about something that none of us ever are familiar with, but in the same original style, right? Most of us are probably not familiar with an African thumb piano. I think her essay would have just been kind of dead in the water at that point. And so here's another thing, right? Not only has she had so much success with this essay getting into college, but she's achieved national fame. Business Insider, NBC News, Cosmopolitan, Inc. Magazine, Quartz, and it just goes on have interviewed or covered Brittany's story. She's reached national fame with this essay. Why? It's because things that are surprising, like her essay that's original and familiar, also get greater word of mouth, right? There's another research that shows that just simply things that are surprising get spread more. People want to share those things more. This is why Brittany's essay was so effective. And there's one last thing I want to talk about. Here's something you probably are familiar with, right? The invisible gorilla experiment. It's a really old experiment in which participants were watching a video of people passing a basketball. There were some players in white shirts, and you were supposed to count how many passes the players in white shirts made with their basketball. So people were really set on watching these players pass, and they were counting the passes, right? But during this experiment, a gorilla, a person in a gorilla suit, walks through the court, spends about 9 seconds walking through the frame of this experiment. Half the people miss the gorilla. I mean, it's shocking. And so a lot of people who analyze this experiment talk about how this shows that we have the selective blindness. When we're paying attention to something, we miss everything else. But I think there's also a really interesting change of perspective if you think about this experiment. We're the gorilla. We're the ones in the gorilla suit. No one's paying attention to us. We're walking in the frame of stuff and nobody sees us. Why? Because people are paying attention to the familiar, right? What would have happened if the basketballs changed color or the people in white shirt, if someone had just left the game? I bet you would have noticed that, right? Because that would have been in the context of the familiarity of the task. And so as you go out and you're trying to get attention, remember, you know, I've taken a writing class that the professor was hell-bent on, you know, you can be original, but tap into something that everybody is talking about. Tap into the news, right? Now my news feed is filled with articles from Vanity Fair, People Magazine, right? Because I want to know what pop culture is. And so you'll see I'm writing essays about things like Ben Affleck, ramen noodles, stealing cars, right? But they're all very original after that. They kind of hook into something that a lot of people are talking about and a lot of people are familiar with, and then it goes on and it becomes very original from there. And these things have spread. A lot of these posts of mine have gone viral now because I've tapped into that, because I've worked hard to make them original and familiar. So I hope that helps as you're trying to craft content, products. It's a really great tip to, you know, get things to kind of stick in people's minds and to get them to spread the word about it. Don't be the gorilla. Thanks. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel. My COO, Lynette at HiRise, says I need to get 200 subscribers to this YouTube channel before she will invest in some better audio and visual equipment. So please let us get to 200 subscribers, and this whole channel will get a lot better soon. So I will see you later. Have a great week. Bye.